So, focus. I want to close with focus. I want to close with focus. Because when you start, if you notice it, when you try to start any kingdom thing, I'm going to pray more. I'm going to fast more. I'm going to witness. I'm going to do this. The enemy sitting like he comes right there to break your focus. The moment you make up your mind, I'm going to do this, sit like all kind of hell will break loose to distract you. Those who fasted, watch all the discounts and all the ones, even the haters, going to be texting you. Hey, you know, I need to talk to you. I treat you to a meal. But you got to say, wait a minute, hold up. I tell you what. You're going to treat me to a meal? Yeah. April 22nd. Treat me to that meal then. Why then? Because right now I'm working on some things. You don't got a parade. I'm just working on some things. Focus. I said, when commitment. Oh, let's go to Proverbs 4:23. Because you're going to see the power of God. The also scripture you want to focus on, Isaiah 58. Proverbs 4:23. Keep your heart with all diligence. So you got to work at it. For out of it are spring the issues of life. Okay? Next verse. Put away from you a deceitful mouth. Okay, so that means you got to work on your mouth. And your eyelids look right before you. Ponder the path of your feet and let all your ways be established. Do not turn to the right or to the left. Remove your foot from evil. When commitment is married to focus, you make a great impact. We have intentions. We have desires. But now God said, hey, you need focus and you need commitment to have these things come to pass, not just a good feeling. Broken focus is what the enemy used to distract and destroy people's destinies. Now, focus is giving priority attention to an effort that you want to see desired results. Joshua chapter 6, verse 10. 1 Kings chapter 13, 7 through 10. Psalm 27, verse 4. Because this next quarter, you're going to be more focused. Psalm 27. One thing I have desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after. Focus. One thing. That I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life to behold the beauty. Philippians 3:13. Focus. People of impact are people of focus. Philippians 3:13. Brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended. But one thing I do, I'm focused, forgetting those things which are behind. Can't do nothing about that, but I'm going to reach forward to those things which are before me. Luke 19, verse 10. Focus. Next 21 days, you're going to be focused. This week is going to be a focus week. Luke 19, 10. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. Jesus, a person of focus. 1 John 3:8. He who sins is of the devil. For the devil has sinned from the beginning, meaning he that practices sins. So you really want to get somebody reared up? You're none but the devil. And I can show in the Bible you ain't none but the devil. I mean, you're nice and all, but you're nothing other than he that's sins of the devil. You are the devil. Boy, that won't get them in, but that'll get a conversation. But don't go that route. This part. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. He was focused. So we can be focused. Okay? Now, benefits of being focused. Number one, it helps you to keep your passion and your fire. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2. Men and women of focus, they're people that are on fire. Focused people are people that's on fire for God. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2. Lord said, write the vision, make it plain on the tablet, that he may run who read it focus. For the vision is for an appointed time, but at the end it will speak and it will not lie. Though it tarry, stay focused, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Have a vision. Vision for your life. Vision for your family. Number two, focus helps bring acceleration to speed. Lord, it seems like things are taking so long. And now they're taking so long, you're on in 1 second, you're off on the next. But now you're going to be focused. When the vision is clear, there's acceleration towards a known goal. How many times that when you had a vision to buy something, that it may take maybe 2 months or 30 days or 60 days, that all of a sudden you got more focus. Mm-hmm. And you saved that money, you didn't spend everything, and you got your desired result because you was what? Focused. You had a vision of what you wanted. Mm-hmm. Focus shields people from evil. Proverbs 4, 27. Because we heard the saying, which is true. Idle mind is a what kind of workshop? And how many know that to be true by, don't raise your hand. But I'm sure you heard that. Focus gives one opportunities of impossibilities. Mark chapter 9, 23. Jesus said, if you can believe, stay focused. If you can believe, all things are what? Possible to those that believe. But you got to stay focused on believing that what Jesus said is true. Focus establishes impossibilities that become possibilities in your life. Focus. That's why the enemy always wanted to break out focus. Genesis chapter 11, verse 6. See, to be easily distracted is to be easily defeated. You always let somebody, what they said, get you. Why they said that? No, just stay focused. Just stay focused. Yeah, they said it, okay. Stay focused. What you got to ask yourself, what were you doing prior to that situation? I promise you, you was in it. You was sitting that thing, but the moment that the wind blew, because the enemy knows what to get somebody to say that right then. So now all of a sudden, you from here to now you're over there. Now you spend your mental energy, time. Well, why did they say that? For they didn't have to say that. I didn't appreciate that. You're off base. Now, minutes pass, sometimes days and weeks, because you're over there. God said, no, stay over here. You was right there. You just allowed that situation to take you off focus. Sometimes it could be a good thing, but it may not be the God thing. Wow, that's good. Genesis chapter 11. Verse 6, and the Lord said, indeed the people are one. They all have one language, sounding pretty focused. And this is what they begin to do. Now nothing they propose or imagine to do will be withheld from them. Focus. So don't let somebody tell you, well, no, that won't work. It won't work for you. But God said, if I can believe, and he'll give me a way to do it, impossibilities become possible. Focus brings power in your life. Stay with me. You know, I feel like that's what I'm trying to do. Well, what it is, you got to be focused. I seem like I just can't stay focused. Philippians 4:13 to help you. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. And the Lord said, indeed the people. No, that's the same one. Acts 1, 14. Focus brings power. That's why the enemy constantly trying to destroy, distract, defeat you and I from being people of focus. Yeah. It's not so much the person with all the skill that makes it to the top. The person had more focus. These all continue with one accord in prayer and supplication. With the women and the Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brethren. These all continue with one accord in prayer. All continue. There was what? There was focus. What happened? Acts 2, 1 through 4, they got the Holy Ghost. Because there was focus in prayer. There's power waiting for you if you only get focus. What happened? We live in a time now, is so many easy distractions. We can stay home, be in a bed, and be full of distracted. Have that phone? I can't get out of bed and do nothing. You can't turn off that phone. Just turn off the phone. Let's see how fast you stay in that bed then. Give me my phone back. No, you say you can't do nothing. See, what distracts you is what you got in your hand. If you put this thing down for a moment and pick this up. Well, we always looking for a bigger room.
But I have Bible Gateway, and I can see my Bible on my...
You could, but right now you're not. So how about we just power off? Tell the devil. Now it's the devil if I power off. Maybe that's why I need to go on the fast, because I'm addicted. Somebody may be trying to call me. Is that somebody may be trying to call you, or that you just wanted to check out your last news feed? You're not really concerned about somebody calling you. Oh, I'm sorry. You might be. Am I talking about... One brother said, Pastor, is it as fast I'm going to go on? I'm going to fast from being on the internet. He said, that's the hardest thing. I'd rather eat. He said, I didn't know how much on my free time I'm hitting that internet. But he said, I got to admit, that was one of my most growth times in my walk with God. Is the Lord talking to you? Somebody says, no! Next. Focus brings success. Philippians 3, verse 14. Now, as I close, what do I need to do to enhance my focus? Psalm 36, verse 9. Why I'm giving this on focus? Because we're serious about this prayer and fasting. And then we're going to try to fight you tooth and nail to get you distracted. And you may not be praying and fasting, but for those who decide, we say, hey, we want to give you some instructions, some keys. So this one will be better than the last one. And if this is your first time, well, you join at a good time. Watch what God will do for you. Because I found out this, that what I experienced from God's word, and now is not only because I believe it, and that settles it, but I experienced what he said. It's one thing to know, to say, yeah, Jesus is the Savior. It's another thing to say, not only the Savior, but he's my Savior. And let me tell you how good he is. That's the same way with prayer and fasting. It is true, but let me tell you, when you pray and fast, God reveals things to you. And you see things that you never saw before. And experiences you like you never experienced before. And those issues and those habits and those hang-ups, oh, you'll see what God will do for you. Psalm 36, verse 9, quickly. What can enhance your focus? For with you is the fountain of life. In your light, we see your light. Light of God's word. So what can enhance my focus? The light of God's word. Proverbs 4, verse 26. What can enhance my focus? A continued revision of doing what God told you to do. Ponder the path, let all your ways be established. Don't turn to the right or to the left. Remove your foot from evil. The thing that you know that ain't going to help you, don't go there. Okay? What can enhance your focus? Connection to focused leadership. You're around focused people, you become more focused. You're around people who have less godly convictions, you become less godly. You hang around liars, you wonder why you start to tell one every blink. Number four. I should use a better example. You hang around gossipers, all of a sudden you start to be, you hang around messy people, you wonder why you get moved towards mess than God's message. Focus. Personal discipline. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 26 through 27. Okay, just so you know. What are some dimensions of focus? How many people am I? I just want to know. Because I'm dropping a whole lot. But how many people kind of helping you out? Because I promise you, this 21 days would be a defining moment in our life. Because we're not doing this abracadabra, hocus pocus, waiting for God to do something for me. But we're just doing what he says. Hey, you do this. He said, this kind of come out by prayer and fasting. Okay, you want to see a change? A, B, C, and D. But let me tell you, does the enemy want to distract you? Not with nothing real bad. Oh, no, with the good things. So you say, I see you because I went to church. Now I can be more focused. What are the dimensions of focus? Focus my heart and my mind on what? God's word. Proverbs 23, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Focus on what God's going to do for you during this time of prayer and fasting and consecration and what you want God to do, because you wrote your vision down, you made a plan, and you're writing. Focus. When you focus on that, then take Ephesians 3:20. Now unto him is able. No, that's Jude chapter 1, verse 20. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly, above and beyond that I can ask or think. Number two, focus your time. You don't have time to waste. Ephesians 5, 15 and 16. Redeem the time because the days are evil. Number three. Everybody say number three.
Number three.
Focus on your actions. Proverbs 4, 26. Out of the message, out of the Living Bible. Don't get sidetracked. Focus on your actions. Number five, four. Focus on the resources that God has given you. Luke 22:35, and by all means, focus on your associations. Proverbs 27, verse 17, and I'm going to close with that. Focus on your associations. Focus on your associations. Proverbs 27, verse 17. Focus on your associations. The Bible says, as iron, sharpened iron, so man sharpens the countenance of his friends. Focus on your associations. Why? Because those who are not going in your direction is not qualified for your association. We love everybody. We love abundantly, but we relate selectively. Jesus loved everybody, but he said, I'll just deal with the 12 right here. You have to know your leaks. And many times we don't know our leaks. But after you leave some conversations, you now, your mind are more carnal things than spiritual things. And you're now trying to get yourself worked back up again. You wonder, what in the world? You just was leaking and you didn't realize it. L-E-A-K-S. Your friend is not who make you laugh. And let's have fun. Your friend is the one who flames your fire that God has given you. Friends is not just for association. Friends are for impartation. And you cannot follow wrong associations and end up in the right destination. And remember, anybody you give your ear to, you're giving them a part of your life and your destiny. So be personal, deliberate, and disciplined to maintain your focus. There's a man, there's a woman in Judges. She gave the word of the Lord. Gave the word of the Lord to the man and said, how God wants to give you the victory. He allowed fear. Instead of focusing on faith, he focused on fear. So he was afraid, knowing this was the word of the Lord. But his focus was on fear, which allowed that to be his distraction. That became his main attention and the main attraction. So she said, okay, no problem. God's going to do it. And God is to do it through me in so many words. So while they're in battle, the enemy's running. Who's running? The enemy. She called the enemy in her camp. The enemy's running, killing God's people. She called the enemy in the camp. Not only she called the enemy in the camp, she said, come on, let me rub your hair. I know you're tired. Broke his focus. And he had a headache that took him to eternity. She took the peg and nailed it to the head and told God's people, okay, battle's over. How did she do it? Focus. How did she defeat the enemy? Broke his focus. So when the enemy trying to break your focus, say, no, you're not going to break my focus because I am focused for the rest of this year, and this next month going to be greater focus. So whatever you may bring, the fight is on. But I win because I see now. Let's look back in our life and take inventory for the last 90 days and say, was it the devil? Was it people? Or was it that I just got off focus? Let's evaluate. So before you just kind of, in Jesus' amen, and go back to the car and then pray the same prayer, wait, hold on. Let me look back. Where I was blaming, hold it. No, I just allowed myself to get off focus. So I was giving the devil more credit than I should have. Okay, so I thought I had money. I didn't have money. No, you had money, but you just allowed yourself to get distracted instead of being focused in where your money should have been going. Okay, I see now, God. I'm gonna win more souls. Gonna be more what? Focus. I'm saying, God, who can I witness to? God said, I bring them to you every day. I bring them to you on your phone. You don't have to leave. They're right there. They're crying out for help. And we say, oh, God, no, I need to go over here. But I promise you, more testimonies, more victories, all because you became focused. Pastor, that doesn't sound so spiritual. Jesus set his face towards Jerusalem. And it's time for us to set our face towards God's purpose for our life. Who deciding to be more focused this month? So let's pray a focused prayer. Let's pray a focused prayer. So Father, Jesus is the pattern son. He did not allow the disciples to break his focus. Jesus, the pattern son. When Jesus asked them to pray, they decided to sleep. He did not allow that to break his focus and still praying. Jesus, the pattern son, when Peter denied and Peter spoke contrary, he did not allow the people in his world to break his focus. He said, for this purpose, he knew his assignment in John 13. We see the miracles, we see the signs and the wonders, but oftentimes we miss how focused he was. But he was able to be focused to do what God called him to do. So we are doing what you put in our hearts to do. But we hit and we miss and we hit and we miss and we say if we have more time. No, we are redeeming the time today. Because we are coming in agreement with your written word and your will for our life. So we say thank you right now for helping us. We receive the grace to be more focused in our practical life, in natural dealings of life, and then in our spiritual life. Thank you that we'll be more focused this afternoon, that we will not waste time, but we'll be frugal with our time. That God, that in times of rest, we rest. Times of enjoyment, we enjoy. In times that you call us to do, we do those things. Because we'll be focused people. And we're going to see tremendous results in our life, all because of what we decided to do in agreement with your will. So, Lord, we just thank you and we bless you. And we give you praise and we give you glory. Somebody help me praise the Lord.